Ahoy! Today we're talking about new items for Season 8. We've talked about some of them before, but a lot of them have been changed, new ones have been added, and this is basically the most final version that we will see before the Season 8 announcement next month, so don't expect any changes to them anymore in terms of what we will learn about. All of the credit for the data mining here goes to Daredust, who has been putting a ton of work into updating this constantly, so huge shout out here. And keep in mind that since it's data mined, it's always subject to change. With these disclaimers out of the way, let's jump into it. So the first item here is largely unchanged, and that's Bluestone Pendant, but the upgrade is changed. Bluestone Pendant itself gets a very minor nerf, with the physical power being decreased from 15 to 10, along with the 15 HP5 and MP5 that it still has, and the passive is also unchanged. Ability damage leads to additional damage over time, physical damage over time over 2 seconds, with a maximum of 2 stacks. The secondary version is also unchanged, the Bluestone Amulet, so we're not going to talk about that again. But there is a new version, and that is Corrupted Bluestone. This comes with 60 physical power, 20 HP5 and 20 MP5. The passive? Enemies hit by your damaging abilities take an additional 75 damage over 5 seconds and reduced enemy attack speed by 10% with a maximum of 2 stacks. For every enemy afflicted, you gain 15% attack speed up to a maximum of 5 enemies. So this is a very, very interesting one. Compared to Bluestone Amulet, the damage is obviously a fair bit lower, which comes with 30 base damage and 7.5% scaling, which even against a 2000 health target is plenty more than we would see here. And it also ticks slower at the same time. But then the attack speed reduction is very interesting as a counter tool to attack speed focused teams, which we don't really have all too much of, especially not of the aggressive kind. Yes, you have Frostborn Hammer in a sense, but that's basically about it. And then at the same time, getting 15% attack speed per target for every target you hit is also very interesting, because that means that a god that would have a big AoE could actually benefit from this a lot. So think, for example, Hunbats. If you hit everyone with your ultimate, then suddenly you have a Hunbats with an additional 75% attack speed, which is kind of odd. And it also comes with more power, so very strange item overall. I think especially Set would be a very good user of this, because you can hit a lot of enemies very quickly throughout a teamfight with your 3. So that is someone I could imagine making good use of it, but then also some others where it could fit in pretty well. So I'm really not sure how exactly this is meant to work. I think it would be very OP on some characters and then kind of weird on others. It's also interesting because it's generally an ability-focused item, but then it comes with a massive amount of attack speed. At the same time, you also have gods that can really barely make any use of it. Think, for example, Awilish, who's typically single-target focused. So yeah, strange mix. The next one is Death Toll, which gets a change to its numbers as well. The physical power stays at 10, but the magical power goes down from 25 to 20, and the health goes up from 50 to 75. Also, the passive is drastically changed here. Now, even the first rank here is percentage-based instead of working with a flat value. So, hitting an enemy with a basic attack now restores 1% health and 1.5% of your mana. Basic attacks that hit all enemies in an AoE restore 0.5% health and 0.75% mana on every enemy after the first hit. This can be upgraded at level 20. Now this means that on very early levels, you're likely going to heal a little bit less with this, but at the same time, on higher levels, you're going to heal a lot more. I imagine this has something to do with them not wanting it to be too much of a hunter item, but rather something that benefits from you building tanky, because then the percentage healing is obviously more beneficial as you have a bigger health pool. The first upgrade version, Death Embrace, gets an adjustment to its values, with the physical power going up from 65 to 80, and the magical power going up from 85 to 140, so a pretty heavy power item now, and it also comes with 200 health. The passive is unchanged here, it still is just an amped up version of the lower tier death toll with a 3% restore, respectively. The secondary version gets a new passive though. Death Temper comes with 50 physical power, now 30% attack speed instead of 20%, 100 health, and the passive is now: when an enemy dies near you, you gain 1 stack of temper that provides 3.5% increased basic attack damage for 10 seconds, maximum of 10 stacks. When an enemy god dies near you, you gain 5 stacks. So this is still an ADC version overall, for sure, but a very strange one because it basically removes the original passive now. I honestly find this item a little bit strange, since the maximum that you can get out of a single target here, if it's a guard, is 15% attack speed. That brings it up to 50 power and 45% attack speed, which is most certainly not bad. But if we compare that to the insane levels of attack speed that you can reach with Corrupted Bluestone, for example, just by hitting someone with an ability once, you also get 15%. I don't quite see the selling point of this one. It seems very conditional unless you're stacking it on a wave beforehand, and typically those items don't gain all too much popularity, see for example Talisman of Energy. The next item is Gilded Arrow, the farming starter for hunters. The first version of it now has 20 basic attack damage instead of 15. This is not power, just basic attack damage. It now has 7 MP5 as well, which gives you a little bit more usability of this in lane without something else in combination with it. It also comes with 50 health, and the passive is now every 10 seconds, the highest health nearby enemy minion is marked. If you secure the killing blow on that minion, you gain 10 bonus gold and now 20% attack speed for 8 seconds. It used to be 15 for 5 seconds. And you restore 30 mana as well. This can be upgraded at level 20. So as you can see here, they encourage prioritizing that minion even more now with the higher attack speed bonus for longer and the extra mana along with the bonus gold. The second version, Honored Arrow, now has 80 basic attack damage instead of 70, still 100 health, and it also provides you with 20% attack speed now. Other than that, it's not changed. The third version, the Diamond Arrow, keeps its 60 basic attack damage and 150 health, and the passive is now all sources of gold gain are increased by 20% instead of 15%. Also, for every 100 gold you have, you gain 1% attack speed and now 0.8% critical strike chance, up to a maximum of 25 stacks. This used to be 1% each, so the crit chance is slightly lowered here for a total of 20% instead of 25%. Now, obviously, Danzaburo comes to mind here, but he actually doesn't benefit directly from gold hoarding in any way, because that's through his passive anyways. The other version, I think, is way more interesting, which can now go up to 60% extra attack speed if there are kills happening. The axes largely remain the same. These are essentially a little bit of Warrior's Blessing that we have at the moment. The only one that's changed here is the base version, which now has 75 health instead of 50 and 15 physical protection instead of 10. Outside of that, it still comes with 10 magical protection, a 2% damage reduction, and the passive being damaging an enemy guard steals 25 health away from your target and restores it to you. This effect can only occur once every 10 seconds, can be upgraded at level 20. Just to very briefly go over the upgrade version if you haven't seen them yet. Sundering Axe comes with 250 health, 35 physical and magic protection, and the passive is damaging an enemy guard steals 10% of their current health away from your target and restores it to you. This effect can only occur once every 7 seconds. And the other one is Hero's Axe, which comes with 400 health, 35 magical and physical protection, and 30% crowd control reduction. Passive being, when an ally guard around you within 55 units is hit by a hard crowd control effect, give them a shield equal to 15% of your maximum health. This effect can only occur once every 8 seconds, which I think is a very, very interesting passive. Swift Wing is still on this list as well, but as both versions are still completely unchanged, I am at this point assuming that they scrapped the idea of including Swift Wing, or they just didn't add it in here at all. Because it would be somewhat weird to include it here without ever testing any changes to it at all. So we're not going to talk about that again, but we're going to talk about Mannequin Scepter, which got a complete rework on everything, basically. The base version of Mannequin Scepter used to have 10 physical power. That's turned into 10 basic attack damage. It also used to have 10 physical protection, which is increased to 15 physical protection. It now also comes with 3% damage reduction, which is very interesting for this item, which was primarily meant as a jungle invade item once upon a time. The passive is enemies hit by your basic attacks are burned, taking 20 physical damage over 2 seconds, which used to be 10, and they have their attack speed reduced by 7%. In return, the 4% slow is entirely removed from the item. Jungle monsters take 2.5 times the amount of damage, this used to be twice. This effect can stack up to 4 times, can be upgraded at level 20. So a very drastic shift in what this item does here. I think the slow ended up being too strong. Once again, they've had that issue before when it was first tried on PTS in an earlier season. It was just too good for aggressive invade-focused playstyles, and by reducing attack speed instead, you can still get away at the same rate, you just can't box very well. With the projections and damage reduction on it, I could still imagine it working pretty well as a solo item though, if you're playing an aggressive solo laner. It just works better if your enemy is also an aggressive solo laner, ironically, since then the attack speed reduction will do more for you. The first upgrade, Mannequin's Mace, now has 50 basic attack damage, which used to be 40 physical power, comes with 100 health, 30 physical protection, and 8 damage reduction. I don't know if this is 8%, I don't think so. I think this is actually a flat value, which is something Hyrus went away from for a while, but it seems like they're bringing this back for this particular item. So this could be very good against Dot Gods in a way as well. Enemies hit by your basic attacks are burned, taking 60 physical damage over 2 seconds, and have their attack speed slowed by 10%. No longer have any movement speed slows though. Jungle monsters and bosses take quadruple damage. This effect can stack up to 4 times. So pretty solid damage against the jungle camps at this point, which makes this interesting because you would think this is more of a solo item with all the defense on it, but that kind of encourages on jungle as well. So not quite sure which direction this is going in. It feels like a bit of a mix of both at this point. But I do think it's very interesting how much emphasis they're putting on basic attack damage items that don't come with any power. We have multiple of those now, which is not what it used to be, which makes me think that even other items that might get changed will possibly move in this direction of just being more focused on basic attack damage and ability damage is more separate. And then there is also Mannequin's Blade, which now comes with 75 basic attack damage instead of 65 physical power, and also with 30 physical protection and 5% damage reduction. The passive here is unchanged. If you have not taken or dealt damage in the last 5 seconds and hit enemy god, jungle monster, or jungle boss, they immediately take 20% of their maximum health as physical damage and are slowed by 20% for 5 seconds. So this one still keeps the movement speed slow, which in my opinion makes it the most interesting one by far, especially in combination with that high percentage damage as well. The only downside is that you have to have been out of combat for 5 seconds, and if you use blink a lot then you know how annoying 2 seconds can be already. And then there is Bamba's Dagger. This gets a very interesting change too. So this comes with 50 health and 50 mana. The passive is now your basic attacks deal plus 15 true damage and your abilities plus 30% damage instead of 25 previously versus jungle camps. When a jungle monster is killed, you will be healed for 10% of the monster's health and restore 25 mana. However, you no longer get the additional 4 gold from this. And that is very, very interesting to me. Also, still has the note, obviously, that it's upgradable at level 20. So what this makes me think, especially with other roles getting other items for extra gold gain, is that possibly jungle will be changed in a different way to provide extra gold through camps. Maybe the gold values on camps will just be higher, or there will be something else that determines that the jungler gets more from camps or something. But something that basically stops the old sharing meta from becoming the thing again. And I'm very curious how that's going to happen. It may also have something to do with the map layout. Maybe the map will be that much larger that camps being shared as often is not even a concern. So we'll have to see. But I read a lot into this particular change because it's very noticeable here that they take that particular aspect away from jungles. Then there is Bamba's Spear, which now comes with 60 physical power instead of 50, and 90 magical power instead of 75, as well as the 200 health and mana. The passive is now your basic attacks deal plus 50 true damage, used to be 30, and your abilities also 50% damage instead of 30% against jungle camps, structures, and jungle bosses. When any of these die, you're healed for 10% of their health, restore 10% of your mana, and are given 10 gold. So the upgraded version still comes with a gold bonus. Now, maybe this is something you can upgrade relatively early and that's how it's meant to work, because the stats on this item are not insane compared to others. It is a good amount of power, don't get me wrong, but compared to many other items that we have now, it's not a super late game choice. So I'm thinking that this may just be a bridging item that's maybe not upgraded at level 20, but earlier, or there's something completely different going on, or they haven't crossed out the passive here just yet. The other version was the one that really stood out though, and that is Bamba's Hammer. Bamba's Hammer actually gets a buff to its health, with that being increased from 200 to 300. Additionally, it provides 200 mana, and now comes with 20% cooldown reduction instead of 10%, so a lot better base stats. It also provides 10% penetration now, so very much a late game item in that regard. The old passive, however, is completely removed. The stun that it used to apply on your next basic attack no longer exists, and I'm not surprised. That sounded very, very, very strong, so yeah, I didn't think it would make it into the final version, to be honest. The new passive is, after casting an ability, your next basic attack deals additional 80 true damage. After hitting a basic attack empowered by Bamba's Hammer, your active cooldowns are reduced by 1 second and you are healed for 5% of your maximum health. And what's really crazy about this, in my opinion, is that it sounds like this is repeatable and there doesn't seem to be an internal cooldown. So every time you use an ability and then a basic attack, you would get the extra 80 true damage and you would get a cooldown reset on all your abilities. It seems that it even includes your ultimate. That along with 5% healing would massively increase the potential of any attack canceling. I do think that at times attack canceling is a little bit overvalued in Smite. I actually wanted to talk about that at some point. But if this item works the way it sounds, then that would no longer be the case. Then attack canceling would be what you want to do on everyone all the time, because it's such a massive benefit from doing so. I'm really surprised this item doesn't come with any form of limiters, and also seems way better than the other upgrades, so not sure what's going on there. At the same time, it's also weird that this one doesn't have any power by itself. So very unusual. We're going to see how that turns out. We'll look into the rest of the items over the upcoming days, so if you need the channel, hit your sub button and maybe the bell so you get notified of that. And also, I'm going to announce my Patreon very soon, so if you're interested in that, make sure to stay tuned. It's coming very, very soon. I know I've said that many times, but this time it's finally happening. With that, thank you guys very much for watching. I hope to see you for the next one very, very soon. Duke Sloth, out.